And as we mentioned at the start of the show, yeah, today is St. Joseph's Day. I may have said St. Patrick's Day and the tradition of Zeppola all around Rhode Island this week. But what does the Zeppola have to do with St. Joseph's Day? And why do we wear red on this day? Here this morning with all of those answers to those questions is our friend, TV maitre d' himself, Joe Zito, who I said, well, I may not recognize you outside of the Rhode Show.
I know, I'm so happy to be here. And of course, I know why you invited me here today.
Why is
because
that?
Like the Zeppola,
yes,
I'm a legendary Italian delight.
You
so,
are?
So, I mean, who better? Who better to have here to and talk have, about this fabulous pastry?
And you have your luxurious hair.
Oh, man.
Which goes along with it.
All right.
Well, okay, don't rub it in.
Nice to see you.
And I love you, too.
I know.
All right, let's get to it. Let's talk about the tradition itself, because there's an article in the paper today. So many people, we got these this morning from, but there are so many places that actually make these.
My
and
friend,
there's all different styles,
My
too.
Good friend Gail Champa, food editor at the Journal, wonderful piece in this morning's paper for all of the viewers who can go see it online, get the paper, and realize, of course, there are literally hundreds of wonderful places to buy them. The thing is that there are so many varieties, just like everything else in our world now. Now, this pastry has origins to a Neapolitan baker in 1840, Pasquale Pintoro.
With a name like that.
Yeah. Now, of course, when you say that in Rhode Island, you're always going to have somebody. It doesn't fly for Rhode Island. My grandmother's aunt's uncle's third cousin's seventh. He was making them in 1839. But you understand that this goes back a way. It's this is, of course, a time of Lent. Things are meatless. This is a way. This is a day of celebration. We wear red. It's a part of the Italian flag. It comes on the heels, of course, of wonderful St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
So it's a festive day. And of course, St. Joseph is a patron saint.
My middle name, I'm Joseph.
In Italy. But people may not realize, Will, that this is a very, very special day to Polish Americans and people in Poland, people in Spain. It's not just indigenous to Italy and then Italian Americans here.
So it's worldwide.
It's a wonderful day. Now,
As far as flavors, because I've had them where they have the Bailey's Irish Cream in them, there's a lot of different places. They have their own tricks. And everyone here in Rhode Island has their place that they automatically will go to in the morning to bring them to work, bring them home, bring them to the family.
And you should.
Yes.
And of course, this originally started as a fried confection. Of course, the years go by now, and the old school bakeries offer both. They offer fried and baked. But of course, you know, just like choice comes and dietary considerations today, so many people are making fried. There are also many places have a variety of wonderful fillings. You could see some of those in the paper today. Of course, Vesta Bakery in Westerly, as it says in the paper, they even have one named after my favorite Italian rock band, you know.
And what is that?
Led Zeppola.
There you go.
They have one. And they're filled with chocolate.
He's full of them.
Yeah. And they're filled with chocolate, and they're incredible. So the fact is you can get these anywhere. And my friend Felicia in East Greenwich, they do nothing but baked Zeppola. And she's got a wide variety. Irish cream, pumpkin, all sorts of wonderful things. So the sky can be the limit. But traditional people like them with the custard, the ricotta cream.
Sure.
And generally, old schoolers will have these that are fried. Even in this day and
even
age.
In this
so
day
a lot
age.
Of bakeries make both types.
Because they're only having them really once a year at this time of year. And without this, this is tradition for so many people to actually bring them in for family.
It's just a happy day. You know, this is also a day traditionally for Italians and Italian Americans that I know of. It's to do something nice for somebody else, not just bring them Zeppola.
Right.
Perhaps if you know somebody that is, you know, not having things go exactly their way now, do something for the poor, do something to be kind. And it's a festive, happy day. And I think it also comes at a great time. We're looking at spring, if it ever gets warm. I'll have to talk to TJ. And, you know, we're looking at all these hopeful things. But that's the history of this wonderful celebration. Well, we know around here that we have it on Federal Hill in October. We do that for the weather.
Right.
But there are many festivals all over the country and the world now, right now, happening.
We've got these here. They probably won't last very long. Thank you, sir, for this. Happy St. Joseph's Day to you. And we are going to dig into these delicious Zeppolas right now that has been provided to us thanks to the original Italian bakery in Johnson. Joe, have a little taste of that.
And go PC.
Yes, we will send it over to our buddy Brendan.
Mm.